Evening, Edgar. Could I get your professional opinion?
Please speak, but I have something important to tell you.
This strain of flu, it's very different from the one I saw in Europe. It's downright peculiar.
Really? What makes you say that?
I've just looked at the blood of one of our recently deceased.
I see. Do you have anything more to go on?
This disease spreads and looks like the Spanish flu, but its effects differ greatly. The London strain is different from the continental one.
This is very interesting. Did you find something else?
Yes. Unlike the flu, the infected begin to show an increase in outwardly aggressive behavior. More than simple agitation. Once docile people become violent.
You mean like rabies? Is there a chance we could create a vaccine, Jonathan, like Pasteur? By the stove, that would be smashing.
There's a lot we're not seeing here, but it is spreading, and quickly. If we don't act, the whole city could be lost.
But Jonathan, we've a fantastic opportunity sitting right here in front of us. A weapon of choice.
What on earth do you mean?
Why, you, my dear boy! With your expertise and your blood, we could isolate the properties that course through your veins. Think about the possibilities.
I admit it did occur to me. Blood seems to be the common factor in all of this.
I totally agree. We're in uncharted territory here. Maybe it's just wishful thinking, but imagine the possibilities.
We'll discuss this more later. Thank you for your time.
No, thank you, Jonathan. But as I said, I needed to talk to you. I have some rather bad news.
Yes?
I'm afraid it's your sister.
My sister?
She's to be buried this evening at Whitechapel Cemetery. Your mother published the obituary this morning.
I see.
I'm sorry, Jonathan. Please accept my condolences.
I need to talk to you, Edgar.
Please do so.
Nurse Crane will not be returning to Pembroke Hospital.
Oh, really? Did something happen? She seems such a very capable woman.
Perhaps too capable. Nurse Crane also ran an illicit dispensary in Whitechapel. I had to ask for her resignation.
I see. Well, we'll just have to manage without her assistance.
So you manage a hospital financed by a vampire?
Yes. Pembroke was founded by Lady Ashbury. She's also our largest donor.
A convenient yet expensive way to have a fresh supply of blood on hand, day and night, don't you think?
All vampires drink blood by nature. Me, I praise the lady's exemplary moral fibre.
If I may inquire, how did you meet her?
Well, Jonathan, she sought me out and offered me the position. It's been a very profitable partnership for both parties.
Do you know anything about the vampire hunters in the East End?
Without a doubt, it's the Guard of Priwen. zealots to the last man.
Where do they come from?
Once they shared the Brotherhood's ideology on non-intervention, but they concluded vampires were a scourge.
They're definitely well organized and equipped.
They're extremely dangerous, not to be trifled with. To them, you're a feral beast, and I, your accomplice.
We'll talk later. I never thought I would have to attend my murdered sister's funeral. Mary, I can't forgive myself. I'll find the truth about what happened to us. I swear. Good evening.
Good evening, Doctor.
I'd like to...
Wise choice, Doctor.
Jonathan, are you all right?
Time is my ally. I'll survive the pain.
I'm here for you, Jonathan. If you ever need to talk.
How do you live with the guilt?
I can't answer that, Jonathan. But we have to accept our nature. Nothing good can come of fighting who we are.
Have you killed someone you've known?
Jonathan, have you forgotten what I do here? I need to meet the men and women I kill.
Have you ever killed family?
I will not answer that. In time, perhaps.
Tell me, why do you finance this hospital?
I'm lucky to be in a privileged position to help those less fortunate. Kindness takes the edge off the years.
If you'll forgive me, it seems a little hypocritical healing those that you may kill.
Jonathan. We are what we are, a paradox. Dead flesh with a lust for life.
And our Dr. Swansea, he's fine with this culling of patients.
Dr. Swansea is a man firmly rooted in the realities of the modern world. He understands what we're trying to achieve here.
Could I ask you some delicate questions?
Ask, and I will answer if I choose.
There's so much I want to know. I mean, what? Where? Who?
Slow down, Jonathan. And please, not all questions should be answered.
Please tell me. Are you Lady Ashbury? Is that your real name?
Yes and no. I was born Elizabeth Samantha Mary Englewood. Out of pure vanity, I cannot tell you when I was born.
Where? I mean, you don't live here.
I have a house in London, where I reside with my daughter.
A daughter? Is she a...
No. Charlotte is a perfectly normal young lady. And if you must know, I adopted. Perhaps you'll meet her someday.
I'll see you later. It's locked. Good evening, Doctor.
Please show.
Of course.
It never ceases to amaze me how you.
Thank you.
It's locked.
Ah!
This is Braille. I need someone who can read this. It's locked, all right. Thank you.
Wait!
It's locked. It's locked, all right. Dear sister, I don't know if I have the strength. Are you all right, miss?
I don't know. Who were those people? They wanted to kill me. Why?
They've lost their minds in the epidemic. They won't come back for now.
You seem to know a lot about them, sir.
I'm Dr. Jonathan Reid. I'm investigating this disease.
I am Xiao Xun. Thank you so much for helping me, Mr. Reid. I must go to the cemetery now. Goodbye.
Shouldn't you go back home, where you'll be safe?
Maybe later. But for now, I need to talk to my husband at the cemetery, Mr. Reid.
It's locked. Carnage. Is Father Whittaker's disciple among the bodies, I wonder? This man's far too old to be Samuel. No. By the look of his clothes, this man's a docker. Samuel isn't here. I had better follow the blood trail.
Ah!
As I feared. Samuel no longer preaches the good word. I can't believe I'm doing this. I have this thirst for blood. I can't believe I'm doing this.